Hey friends, this is Nancy and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm sharing with you a quick Copic coloring video featuring the Anita Jaram Christmas Presents stamp set from Colorado Craft Company. I've been making Christmas cards and decided that it was probably time to shift to holiday tags. In this video, I'll show you how I colored the image, and over on my blog, you can see how I finished the tag. I'll include the link to the blog post, as well as the list of supplies, in the description below. To start, I stamped the image on Hammermill 110-pound paper using Gina K. Design's Amalgam Ink in Obsidian. I die-cut the paper using one of the tags from the Tag Stacklet 2 die set by Tailored Expressions. I started here by coloring the dog in shades of light to medium brown. You'll notice here that I blended from light to dark. I do that sometimes when I want to control the level of the darkest tone in the final result. I have a tendency to extend the darkest tone out too far into the image, so I compensate by switching back and forth between blending light to dark and blending dark to light to match the way I color. You'll see later in the video that I switch the blending to dark to light. It doesn't really matter as long as you're happy with the final results. Blending light to dark does involve more steps, and it probably uses up more ink. I start with the lightest tone to map out my color placement. Then I start deepening the blend by adding the medium tone and switching back to the lightest tone to blend out any harsh edges. I apply the darkest tone, which I blend out with the medium, and then the lightest tone. It's easier to go darker if necessary than it is to go lighter after the fact. So this just helps me see where I want shadows and where I might need to add more depth. During the final layer of the lightest tone, I close up any remaining areas of white that might be too large. Here I'm leaving some areas white as a highlight. Next, I'll start on the packages. I knew that I wanted to use yellow tones on the top package, but yellow by itself can look pretty flat, so I'm underpainting with violet to add some depth. Underpainting is simply the application of one color, in this case violet, as the base for subsequent colors. Traditionally, with Copics, we're taught to use blending trios, a light, a medium, and a dark, but that results in a saturated, vibrant color. You'll get more realistic colors by shading with a desaturated color. In other words, by taking away the vibrancy. So I'm applying violet to the areas that I want to appear rounded, and then I'll apply yellow tones over the top. At this point, I'm going to turn on a little music, let you watch the coloring, and then I'll meet you at the end. Well, that's it for the Copic coloring. Join me over on my blog at the link in the description below to see how I finish the tags. I'd love for you to subscribe to my channel, and if you do, be sure you click on the bell next to the subscribe button below so that you'll receive a notification whenever I post a new video. Thanks for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.